And welcome to the App Inventor Look Extension tutorial. Look Extension is a special extension for App Inventor that uses machine learning to be able to classify images seen through your phone's camera. This tutorial will go through how to make an App Inventor app that uses the Look Extension. First, let's see it in action. So this is the completed app that you'll be making in this tutorial. It has two main buttons that you'll be using. The first is Classify, which will be classifying the image seen through the camera using the Look Extension algorithm. The second is the Toggle Camera button, which changes the direction of the camera from backwards to forwards and vice versa. Let's keep it facing forwards for now. Now, let's see if the app can classify something seen through the camera. Let's try my phone. Let's center it very well and press Classify. And there we go. I classified it as a cell phone with a 41% confidence. Now, let's see how we can actually make this app. Before we get started, it is important to note that the tutorial may not run on every mobile device. It'll generally run on all newer devices, phones and tablets, and this tutorial demonstrates how it works on a Galaxy Tab S2. Definitely keep an eye on the tutorial site for hardware info updates. The reason that this may not run is because the extension includes a full neural network that is downloaded along with it. That way, the app does not need any internet connection or Wi-Fi at all. This network is pre-trained on 1,000 different objects. But remember, if you try and classify an object that has not been trained on, it will certainly classify that incorrectly. We'll discuss more incorrect results at the end. To get started, go ahead and download the starter file for this tutorial from the description in this video. Once you've downloaded it to your computer, open up App Inventor. To upload the project, go to Projects, and then Import Project from My Computer. Then you can choose the file that you just downloaded. Let's take a look at the components we have already set up. First is the status label. This tells us when the app is ready and displays the classification. Next is the spacer. This is an invisible label that makes the app look better. We won't be using this in the block section. Next is the web viewer. This is where the image is displayed when the camera is taking footage to be classified. Next is the horizontal arrangement. This organizes the buttons horizontally and makes the app look good. The Classify button starts up the classification. When this is pressed, the image will be classified using the Look Extension algorithm. The Toggle button controls the camera. When pressed, the camera direction is toggled from forwards facing to backwards facing, and vice versa. And finally, the Look Extension is the extension component that does the machine learning classification work. We have the visual components, but they don't work just yet. To put them all together, let's go to the Blocks Editor. In the Blocks Editor, you'll notice that there are already some existing pieces of code. These are just there to catch some common errors, so we don't have to worry about those. Let's get started. First, let's work on the toggle button. When this is pressed, you want it to switch the direction of the device's camera. So let's click on the toggle button drawer and pull out the When Toggle button is clicked. Next, we'll want to go into the Look Extension drawer and pull out the Call Look Extension Toggle Camera Facing Mode block. With those together, when the toggle button is clicked, it will tell the Look Extension to change the direction of the camera. Now, to be able to run the app, you need to wait for the Look Extension to load and be ready to classify objects. Once it is ready, you can start pressing buttons. It would also be useful for the app to notify us when it's ready to classify objects, so let's code the blocks to do that. First, click on the Look Extension drawer and drag the When Look Extension Classifier Ready block into the workspace. Next, we want the Classify button drawer and pull the Set Classify Button.enabled into the first block. So when the classifier is ready, We want the classify button to be enabled, so let's go into logic and pull out a true block. Now, in addition to setting the classify button to be enabled, we would like the label to say ready. So let's go into the status label drawer and pull out the setStatusLabel.text into the blocks. And we're going to want it to say ready, so let's pull out a text block and just type in the word ready. So in total, when the classifier is ready, it will make the classify button clickable and have the word ready appear on screen. When the classify button is pressed, you want it to call the look extension algorithm and classify the image for you. So let's go into the classify button drawer and pull out the whenClassifyButton.click into the workspace. Now, let's go into the look extension drawer and pull out the callLookExtension.classifyVideoData block and drop it right in there. And there you go. When the classify button is clicked, it will call the look extension algorithm and have it classify the video data. This one purple block packs a lot of punch because it has the entire machine learning algorithm of image classification packed into one single command. Once the look extension classifies an image, you want to see that result displayed on screen. Let's click on the look extension drawer again and go into the when look extension got classification. This block will trigger after the look extension has successfully classified an image. Now, we're going to want to change the status label's text to reflect to that result. So let's go under setStatusLabel.text. Importantly, what the look extension returns is actually at the top 10 classifications along with each confidence level. Right now, you only want the first and most likely classification, so you will return the first item in the list. To do this, let's go under Lists and pull out the Select List Item. Now, the result is already in the block. If you just hover over here and drag the Get Result, this is the output from the classification. And since we went to the first element in that list, let's go into Math, drag out a number, and make that 1. And there we go. This should, as soon as the look extension has gotten the classification, display the first element of that list on screen. At this point, you should have successfully created an image classification app that utilizes machine learning. Congratulations! There are lots of ways to go even further and expand the app. Try using text-to-speech to have the device speak the result, or have it classify still photos instead of video footage. Also, you may remember that it lists out the top 10 probabilities, but we only use 1. You can expand this to list out the top 3 or the top 5, or change the output entirely, depending on the outputs. For example, if all of the confidences are very low, you could simply have the result say, "I don't know." Or if the top 2 are very similar, you could list out both of those as options. To connect your app and test it out, go to the Connect button at the top, click on the AI Companion, and use your mobile device to scan the barcode or input the code yourself. And there you have it, the completed WhatIsIt image classification app. You should be able to have it classify images that are seen through your device's camera. Let's try it and see if it can correctly classify this pen. There we go. It is able to correctly classify it at a confidence of about 63%, which is really quite good. Now, let's try it out on a different object, like this multi-tool. As you can see, it incorrectly classifies this multi-tool as a hair slide with a fair amount of confidence. This is not entirely surprising because neural networks are not going to be 100% correct. But the reason that this was incorrect classified is because, most likely, this neural network was not trained on a lot of images of multi-tools
and so was not able to recognize one that was shown through the camera. This is an example of algorithmic bias, where biases in what is and isn't included in the testing and training for a neural network reflects how this app and its eventual performances work. Go ahead and try out this app on different objects around you and see what works and what doesn't. This should give many insights on how the neural network was trained and tested.